Yep.
I do. I know where you are. So if you take the next turn right and then you'll come to a T-intersection and turn left.
It's late evening and Chris has been called back to the Bondi clinic for an emergency.
All right, we'll see you soon.
So we've got a pug coming in that's expecting pups. They're notoriously difficult at this time. They find it really hard to get their pups through their narrow pelvis. I'm expecting a cesarean, but we're going to have to see it first. And he should be here right now.
How
do
you
go?
Do you want
to
do this?
Yeah, how
are
you going, Chris?
Do you want to bring it straight through?
Yep.
Okay.
Have a look at her.
Thanks, mate.
Since about 10 o'clock this morning, she's been panting, shivering, temperature drop.
Yeah.
John's now regretting his decision to allow Bella to have a litter.
I feel so bad for doing it.
Well, just it's all a bit real now.
Yeah, I mean she's not a breeding dog. She's a family pet. I owned her since she was 6 weeks old.
Yeah,
and yeah. I can't live without her.
Yeah.
Okay. It's okay.
X-rays will confirm just how big the pups are, and how much danger Bella is in.
X-ray.
Jeez. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which is huge for a pug. That's. There's no way a 15-month-old dog is going to have the energy and the reserves and the strength to push out 6 massive puppies. She needs a cesarean. There's no other way of looking at it. I don't know if we're going to get them all out alive, but we really have to give them their best chance.
All John can do now is wait while Chris and his team begin the extremely delicate operation.
They're literally bursting to get out of here. They're almost overflowing here.
Soon after Chris makes an incision, the first of Bella's pups is born, but it's not breathing.
How are you going over there? Give him a breath.
I heard a little noise already. Yeah.
Chris is using mouth-to-mouth resuscitation to force air into the lungs of Bella's first pup.
Plenty of rubs to stimulate.
I've just got rib rotate between rubs, breaths.
It's got a bit of anaesthetics to his system.
Yeah. I'm getting movement.
The firstborn is now breathing, but there are still 5 more pups to be saved.
You ready for me?
I'll do this one.
Outside, a desperately worried John waits and hopes.
Do you want to start on this one over here? She's starting to gasp, and then I'll start on the one that Chris is on.
With so many pups needing urgent attention, even Bondi vet producer Jane Caswell has been called on to help.
Come on, baby. Come on. Keep going. You can do it.
On your shelf. Come on, babe.
He's breathing now.
Yes. That was the first time he's breathing more than once.
Another one coming.
Let's see. Good.
One by one, the pups splutter to life.
How many are in here? Just one?
Two.
There's two here. That's number 5.
You guys are going to need to get a rotation on these guys because Mum's got to...
The last one.
At last, all 6 puppies are successfully out. But any joy is short-lived as the team realises the pups may be out of danger, but Bella is not.
So she's lost a lot of blood. Her heart rate's dropping as well. Her colour's gone from a nice pink colour to quite a pale pink. So we're doing our very best to treat the symptoms of shock that she's going through and blood loss, pumping the fluids through her. But she's a long way from home. She's in a bit of trouble. We're sitting on 70 beats per minute before, we're now up to 74, so we're seeing a bit of a response. It's encouraging, but it's by no means over.
It's a tense time at the Bondi clinic as Chris sews up Bella, who's dangerously weak after delivering 6 puppies.
So we've got 3 girls and 3 boys.
Wow.
And the heart rate's coming up too, so it's all good.
So far. A few more stitches and we're done. Her heart rate's come up to 85 now. Her colour's good. She's looking like she might just make it. But it didn't look that way for quite a while.
Turns out the puppies and Chris have something in common, given it's past midnight.
Why is that a significant time?
Could it be, what, special day?
Probably my birthday now.
Oh, happy birthday.
Poor girl. You should be really proud of her.
Yep.
She did really well. Six live puppies, six out of six.
Tiny.
You can pick them up if you like.
Even though Bella is still feeling the effects of the anaesthetic, the pups urgently need their first feed.
These puppies are new to the world and they need all the help they can get. They need energy quickly.
It's been a long night and John finally feels comfortable leaving Bella's side and going home.
Thanks, John. See you, mate. So she's now at a normal temperature, which is, oh, I don't know, what do you reckon, a relief?
No, not at all.